First, kicking off the hour is Food Network star, finalist, executive chef, and author of the new cookbook, Eggin'. David Rose cooks on the Big Green Egg with recipes covering everything from appetizers to entrees to even smoked cocktails, all on the grill. From Atlanta, let's welcome to the show Chef David Rose. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hello, Tamron. So good to see you. We got to do this more often than once a year. So good to see you, and congrats on the Emmy.
Thank you very, very much. Emmy nomination. I'm just so excited. But listen, here's the deal. I have a green egg. I am obsessed with my green egg. I always talk about the things that Al Roker brought to my life. Brought to my life the Big Green Egg. So you love smoking. You love just that flavor rather than just slapping it on a grill.
Oh, yeah. The smoking adds a whole complex, robust. We're all about leveling up flavors. And smoking, you have different types of wood, different types of charcoal. And that's also an essential ingredient. So when you're smoking, it's important to know what the smoking chips you're using is, as important as the ingredients and the protein. So we're going to show it all today.
We're going to show it all. So today we're going to show, you're going to show us how to smoke seafood. Yeah. It's a smoked seafood boil with shrimp that we can also do even if you don't have a smoker. So I've got the ingredients here. You have a butter that you are quite proud of. I have never heard of making this actually on a grill.
Yes, yes, yes. You know, the whole Eggin' book, it's about taking the world of barbecue, grilling, and smoking, flipping it, and standing it on its head.
Okay.
Where you're bringing unconventional to the grill. So with this right here, summer is super indicative of seafood boils. So why not maximize and really raise the levels of that by putting those same flavors on the grill?
Okay, let's start with this butter. It's a Cajun butter?
Yes, ma'am. I've lived in Atlanta for about 20 years, so I know a little about Cajun and Southern food, and I love it. So first things first, what we have here is we had a little olive oil, garlic, and shallot. These are aromatics right here. You're letting it release those nice fragrances. You're not letting it brown. To that, we are going to add butter, because we are making Cajun butter after all.
I have
a
lot of butter right here.
So you put a little bit of butter in there as well. There you go.
I got four sticks.
There you go. I prefer using an unsalted butter because you can control the salt content.
Mm-hmm.
So with seafood, citrus goes very well.
Nice.
A little bit of lemon zest.
Mm-hmm.
Into that, we have a little bit of garlic powder. Mm-hmm. It is Cajun, so I like a little bit of heat. We have some cayenne pepper.
Yes.
Salt.
Uh-huh.
Black pepper. Smoked paprika for that little smoky note that hits you right back.
I love smoked paprika. Listen, David, smoked paprika is an underestimated spice. You heard it here, ladies and gentlemen.
I got the memo. I brought it. We have here some thyme as well.
Okay.
And a little bit of freshness. We have some Italian parsley. So we put that right there onto the grill because, again, Tamron, we're doing everything on the grill, on the Big Green Egg. So that's step numero uno.
So since we're doing everything on the grill, we were just talking about, even if you don't have a smoker, the chips that you use, and I just bought one of these, and I love these. I actually have a smoker, too, but on my grill, I use this wood chips, soaking the wood chips. And are there specific kind of chips that you favor? I am from Texas. We do a lot of mesquite.
Yes, mesquite, hickory, that's great for Southern barbecue. Your meats, your ribs, your briskets, all that deliciousness. But with this seafood, with this shrimp, with this lobster, we don't want to overpower the taste.
Okay.
We want to kind of nuance and finesse the taste. So we're using some applewood chips or cherry, a nice fruity flavor. Take the seafood, and you're getting a hint of that, a little waft.
How long do you soak your chips for?
At least 2 hours. Way, when you're smoking, the chips aren't burning too fast, and you're getting that nice, slow smoke.
Where do you put that on your grill?
So what you do with the smoke box, you put it right onto the charcoal. So right onto the charcoal, it goes like that. And if you have the smoker, what you want to do is take it and just toss it right there onto the coals themselves.
Okay.
And what it's going to do, it's going to release all that flavor. Get kind of a smoke facial
Love
with
it.
That right there.
Okay, so David, listen, I put my butter on the grill. I'm going to close this grill up because I know we're going to put a little marinade on our seafood here. We've got sausage, we've got corn, we've got potatoes, we've got a little lobster if it's a special occasion, and we have shrimp here.
You know we're real fancy, Tamron. So we have here all the things you'd see on a seafood boil. So what you want to do, again, is kind of infuse those delicious Cajun flavors. And what we have here is salt, again with the cayenne, again with the smoked paprika. Some say paprika. Either way, it tastes good. Garlic powder, onion powder. And when you have a Old Bay or a seafood type mixture, celery seed is what gives it that nice kind of Old Bay-ish kind of flavor. Celery seed and black pepper.
Okay.
And you whisk all these ingredients together till they're nice and friendly.
Mm-hmm.
And then we bring over here our ingredients. The shrimp, the lobster, the corn, the potatoes, and the lemon. I like to char the lemon.
And we just put that marinade right directly on our food in front of us. When we come back, Chef David is sticking around. I'm going to put the marinade on this. We're going to put this on the grill in the break. And when you come back, get ready for some BBQ joy. Don't go anywhere. We are back with chef, cookbook author, and master of the grill, David Rose. Today we are grilling up a smoky take on low country seafood boil. Before the break, David is still with us. I actually put my my lobster, my shrimp, my sausage, all that on the grill. But before I take it off the grill, David, you've got this amazing bread to pair it with.
Yes, ma'am. You gotta have something to sop up all that delicious.
Yes, you do. I love the way you
seafood.
Think.
French bread. What you do, slice this bad boy in half like so. And then you're going to take all those delicious, spicy, unctuous, buttery flavors,
mm-hmm.
and you're just going to slather and bathe it.
So, David, we're using our Cajun butter that
yes,
we put
ma'am.
On our protein on our little garlic bread as well. Oof.
Yes, correct.
That
I'm
is...
all about multi-purpose utilization. If
I
you
like
got it,
that. Yes.
You know?
Yes. Okay.
No waste around here. No waste.
I'm doing my bread here. Now, David, mm-hmm. how long, and I always get this, you know, I get afraid that I'm going to burn my seafood, especially for shrimp. How long on the grill?
For shrimp, about, you know, anywhere from 8 to 10 minutes, depending on how hot your green egg is or your grill.
Okay.
So around, you know, 450, medium high.
Lobster, medium how long for a lobster tail?
Lobster, about the same, about 9 to 11 minutes, depends on the size of the lobster tail, but more so, you want to use your eyes, Tam. You want to use your eyes. When you see that golden brown, flip it.
Okay, well, I got my eyes. I'm opening my grill that I've been grilling in the commercial break, and my eyes tell me that my lobster is ridiculous. My shrimp is scrumptious. I'm ready.
This ain't your first rodeo. It's at least your second or third.
It's at least. So
please,
I've got the garlic bread. After we put that beautiful Cajun butter on there, we put it on the garlic. How long do you toast that for on the grill?
About 30 seconds. Again, it is bread. All you want to do is get some nice char marks on there, some nice caramelization, and have that garlic butter and that breader become one.
Okay.
That garlic butter and bread become one.
Okay, I would not recommend this at home, but I don't have my tongs, so I'm just going to pull this off the grill. I know that's a risky move, but I have done that before. So we've got our beautiful finished seafood, and we have it plated over here. David, my man, on these little cute baskets. When I tell you I am making this for my family immediately, that is the gospel truth. Love it.
Yes, you already know it. So you know you got to finish it with that butter. So slather it with that garlic butter all over.
What? More?
No waste around here. And just drizzle. It's raining.
Okay.
It's raining Cajun garlic butter, and then you finish it with that toasted garlic bread.
Uh-huh.
And that right there, Tamron, that is seafood boil and smoky goodness of the gods.
Okay.
All in one.
David, you just took me to barbecue church. Yeah. I appreciate it so much. I'm going to eat it. Be sure to go to our website for David's recipe on the boil, but also check out his cookbook, Eggin'. David Rose cooks on the Big Green Egg. It's available October 5th, where books are sold.